Welcome to DuckDuckGo. This is a privacy browser that is available for Android and iOS. First thing you got to do, obviously, is download it from the App Store and install it. Once you do that, you can open it up and it brings you straight to the privacy browser with the DuckDuckGo feature, and it gives you a little bit of information about DuckDuckGo. Says that the internet can be kind of creepy. Not to worry, searching and browsing privately is easier than you think. Hit let's do it, and then you can change your settings and make this your default browser. It automatically takes you to your settings, and you can scroll down and make it your default browser instead of Safari. Then we go back to the app, and it gives you a little bit more information. Try visiting some websites. It basically takes you through a tutorial. So we're going to go to board.com, which is a gaming platform, and you will see that there is a pop-up from DuckDuckGo that will pop up on your screen, and it will let you know some information. Says that Google was trying to track you and that DuckDuckGo blocked them, and you can check the address bar to see who's trying to track you and when you visit a new site. And then to clear your tabs, you just click on the clear button, and you can actually change that animation from fire to couple different things. There's a whirlpool. There are a few other options that you can use. Now let's open a new tab, and we'll just type in Facebook to see what happens when we go to facebook.com. And DuckDuckGo will give you a pop-up saying that it can't stop Facebook from seeing what you're doing. It can't stop it from tracking. But if you browse with DuckDuckGo, it can actually reduce what Facebook knows about you overall by blocking their trackers on lots of other sites. So here are a couple different things you can use in the DuckDuckGo platform. New tabs, find a new page, add bookmarks, add favorites, fireproof website, share, request desktop site, disable privacy protection, report broken site, or you can go into the settings of DuckDuckGo. So let's just type in DuckDuckGo in the search bar and see what comes up there. So this is the DuckDuckGo search feature. The searches are anonymous, and it never stores your search history, which is awesome. So if you actually click on settings, you can change the appearance. You can use the light version or the dark mode, which I prefer the dark mode personally. I just think it looks cleaner. You can change the font size, language, infinite scroll you can turn on, open links in new windows, and if we click on other settings, it takes us to the main settings of DuckDuckGo, where you can change your region, your language, safe search, and there's all these other different options to turn on and off, which gives you a lot of control over your DuckDuckGo power. So we push save and exit, and then we can go ahead and click on something else. Again, these are just the settings, the different options that you have within DuckDuckGo. So if we go back to our settings, and we can, here's our theme modes. So if we go into the fire button animation, we can change it from Inferno to Whirlpool, Airstream, or None. And I'll just quickly show you what it looks like if you clear it with the Whirlpool mode on. Go back into settings and just take a look at everything else in here. Global privacy control is on. You can turn that off if you choose to. There's just a lot of power that you have over this, and this is the fireproof sites where the websites rely on cookies to keep you signed in. When you fireproof a site, cookies won't be erased and you'll stay signed in, even after using the fire button. They still block third-party trackers found in fireproof websites, and so you can turn that on or off. You can change to automatically clear your data if you choose to, which will automatically clear everything once you close out of the application. It automatically closes on exit and erases everything for you. So this is just a little bit about how to use DuckDuckGo. Hope you guys got something out of this tutorial. And you can also choose to use it in Safari, like within the Safari platform, which is awesome. So yeah, this is about DuckDuckGo. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Let us know what you think, and we will see you guys in the next tutorial. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to clear your tabs.